In this week's lab, we're going to see what we can learn about plate motion based on the ages of volcanic islands and seamounts produced as an oceanic plate moves over the hotspot. Probably the best known hotspot is the Hawaiian hotspot. Here the Pacific plate is moving northward over a stationary hotspot or magma source in the deep mantle. As the plate moves over that magma source, it produces a chain of volcanic islands and seamounts. That chain is age progressive, meaning there's an orderly relationship between the ages of islands and seamounts in the track relative to their distance from the part of the plate currently over the hotspot. A less well-known hotspot is found in the South Pacific. It's the same geologic setting as what we have in Hawaii, only here the Pacific plate is passing over another hotspot, the Louisville hotspot. Lesser known because the Louisville volcanoes are not tall enough to rise above the surface of the sea as oceans. Instead, they form underwater volcanoes called seamounts. But because they're formed in the same way that the Hawaiian chain is, they also have an age-progressive relationship. And the distance or relationship between distance and age along that track indicates changes in the velocity of the Pacific plate. Here we've plotted age of seamounts in the Louisville chain versus their distance from the youngest seamount, which is inferred to be the part of the plate currently over the hotspot. You're going to do this same exercise, only you're going to be working with the Hawaiian hotspot. You will have data on the ages of islands and seamounts in the Hawaiian chain versus their distance from Kilauea, the active volcano currently over the Hawaiian hotspot. Age on the x-axis, distance on the y-axis. The relationship between distance and age can be used to infer the velocity of the plate as it passes over the hotspot. Remember, velocity is simply distance divided by time. We've plotted distance versus time. So the slope of our line indicates the velocity of the plate as it passes over the hotspot. That velocity may not be constant, but rather the plate may slow down or speed up as it passes over the hotspot. If you're doing this by hand, you'll want to get out a ruler and draw your line representing the relationship between distance and age, which gives us the velocity of the plate as it moves over the hotspot. Where you have a lot of data points, as you do for the Hawaiian hotspot, you're not going to draw a line that connects the points, but rather you're going to draw a single line that best fits those points. Now there's some trial and error involved in this. What I'm doing now is I'm placing my ruler over my data points, and I'm adjusting the position of my ruler in such a way that I have an equal number of points above and below the line that I'm going to draw. I have placed my best fit line for this portion of the track, something like that. And again, the slope of the line, rise over run, represents distance divided by time. In other words, velocity of the plate as it passes over the hotspot.